Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. How are you? I hope you will fine. Today our topic is mathematical logic. In another way, we call it the logic of reasoning. So today we will learn in mathematical logic, learn about the statement, proposition, and learn how to use logical connectives to combine a statement or to compound a statement. After that, we will learn about the truth table. So these are the learning objectives about the mathematical logic. So mathematical logic. Means logic of reasoning. Now, what are the learning objectives today? Number one, first we learn about student. Statement or proposition. Now the second objectives of this lecture, learn how to use logical connectives to combine statements. Now the third objective is to learn about how to draw a truth table and the next one is learn about which statements are logically equivalent. So now we will start a student. So these are the learning objectives. After defining the learning objectives, start now. What is logic? When we talk about logic of reasoning, the first word in your mind, what is logic? Logic is the science dealing with the method of reasoning, dealing with the methods of reasoning. This is called logic. So who is the first person define the logic of reasoning? The Greek philosopher scientist Aristotle, scientist The Greek philosopher and scientist Aristotle is the first person said to be about the logical reasoning. The student, there are some applications of logical reasoning. Many areas of computer science such as digital logic design, automata theory, and computability. And computability. And artificial intelligence. Etc. So there are some applications we have to consider here. Many areas of computer science, such as digital logic design, automata theory, and computability, and artificial intelligence, and up to so on. So, student, when we talk about the logic, in logic, it is divided into two. First one is propositional calculus, and the other one is propositional predicate calculus. The other one is predicate calculus. Propositional calculus means propositional calculus which deals with statements that if it is true or false, it means which statement it is true or false, and what is propositional predicate calculus, which deals with predicates which propositions are which propositions are containing variable. So, student, we will continue the topic. First, we will define the logic. Then, in logic, it is divided into two basic parts. What is propositional variable and propositional calculus and predicate calculus. Then, do you know about the sentence, a number of words making a complete grammatical sentence structure having a meaningful sentence is known as sentence means a number of words making a complete grammatical structure having a meaningful sense is known as sentence. Or in another way, an assertion in logic or mathematics is known as sentence. So, student, assertion may be divided into two parts. First one is declarative sentence. And the second one is non-declarative sentence. So after that, student, we will consider the word proposition or statement. It is very important and basic definition in mathematical logic. When we talk about the mathematical logic, which statement or which proposition is called? Which statement is called proposition? For example, a proposition or a statement is a declarative sentence which is true or false, but not both. It means if you have given a proposition or a statement, if it is declarative, it means it is meaningful sentence, which is true or false, but not both. It is either true or false, but not both. So I explain you and write some statements. So we will consider the examples, students. which type of sentence we consider as proposition in mathematical logic. For example, the first example is ice float in water. It means the given statement is true. So this is called proposition. It means a sentence. In another way, it is a declarative sentence, which meaningful sentence. In another way, we call it proposition. It means it may be true or it may be false. Now the second statement, it is, for example, 2 + 2 = 5. It is false, but it is meaningful. So it is proposition. Now if the given statement we consider here, for example, 2 + 2 = 4, it means true. So the given statement or sentence is called proposition. So these are the sentence, we call it declarative sentence. It means it has meaningful sentence. That's why we call it, is proposition in mathematical logic. China is in Europe . So what does it mean? Now do your homework. I give you some examples about the proposition. What a hot day. Open the door. Close your window. So, student, do your homework. It means it is an order. Order is not a declarative sentence, so that's why we call it, is not a proposition. In mathematical logic, what a hot day. It is an exclamation sentence. It is an exclamatory sentence. It means it is not a proposition. In mathematical logic, open the door, it means it is an order. Close your window, it means it is an order. So if a sentence which shows an order, exclamatory sentence, or order, and a question . So this type of sentence, it is not a proposition. So student, in this way we will learn about the statement, which statement or which sentence is called proposition or which is not a proposition. China is in Europe, it is false, but it is proposition. So after that, student, we will consider the propositional variables. It means we will talk about propositional variables and propositional constants. When we shows or express the propositions, by letters P, Q, R, S, and up to so on. So these are called propositional variable. So therefore, P, Q, R, S are called propositional variables. Variables. Now, propositional constant. So it means the proposition shows that either true or false, so true and false are called propositional constant. So these are the basic things, friend, that we learn about the mathematical logic and mathematical reasoning. Now after that, we will learn about how to use logical connectives. So what are the logical connectives? So there are three basic, there are five connectives we will use in mathematical logic or in a logic of reasoning, this symbol represent here, student, negation. It means if the statement is opposite or and implication or in another way we'll use in conditional statement if the statement is conditional and it is by implication. It means by conditional. So these are the basic connectives we will use in mathematical logic. After that, student, what are the simple proposition? There are two types of proposition: simple proposition and compound proposition. Compound proposition. For example, if we write here, Shayan is healthy, it is a simple proposition. This statement represent here if it is true or if it is false. If the statement, if we represent by the variable constant, the propositional variable p, if we represent by this. But if we write, so this type, this statement is simple proposition. But when we talk about different compound proposition, I give you example. It means if it has two proposition, the first one is it is cold and the second proposition represented here connected with first, it is raining. So when we combine together with the symbol or, it means P or Q. So we write here, it is cold or raining. It means this type of preposition is called compound preposition. But when we represent here, define as P and Q, it means it is cold and raining. So student, when we talk about it is cold and raining, so these are the examples about the conjunction and disjunction. So this symbol P or Q represent here disjunction. This type of statement we call it is disjunction, and when we use here, it means conjunction in language. In English language, it means. But this disjunction, it may be divided if the proposition is disjunction in English word, in English word student, or can be used in two different sense, in two different sense, in two different sense. The first one is inclusive and the second one is inclusive, or it means and or. These are called inclusive or exclusive, means either or. So disjunction, it means when we talk about disjunction, it means P or Q, it has an English word or can be used in two different sense, inclusive and or, exclusive either or. I give you example about the compound proposition and we will convert it is into truth table. I give you some example, then we will move for a truth table. For example, if you have given two statement, the first statement is ice floats in water. Now the second statement we represent by Q variable. 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. When we show that P and Q, it means when we will combine statement ice floats in water and 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. So this statement is called propositional. It is disjunction or conjunction. It means it is conjunction. Then we use here and, or P or Q represent here. Ice float in water, or it means it has choice, 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. So this type of statement, it is called disjunction. Inclusive means and or both condition, when we applying in this way, it is called inclusive. Or either or means exclusive. It means some statement when we consider it is in exclusive way. If we write here student negation of P, it means ice doesn't flow, ice doesn't float in water. And if you find the negation, means 2 plus 2 not equal to 4. Or in another way, it is false that, it is false that 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. In two ways, we will write the answer in negation. It means negative statement. So after that, student, we will continue the topic and define, learn about the truth table. So what we call it, truth table, and how to make a truth table. A table shows that a table shows that the truth values of a single proposition or simple meaning are same of a single proposition or compound proposition. A table shows that the truth values of a single or compound proposition for all possible cases it is known as truth table. So student, I give you some example about truth table. For example, if we write here the first statement, ice floats in water. And if we write negation P, it is ice doesn't float in water. So when we make a table, student, we applying the formula to raise to the power n. It has single proposition. It means it has two possible answers according to truth table. So P, if we P represent here, if the statement it is true or it is false. The student, the given statement, it may be true or it may be false. These are the possible cases. So when we find the negation of P, it means it is, if it is true, then we write it is false. If it is false, then we write here true. So this, I give you an example about the simple proposition. Now compound proposition, if you have, for example, the first statement it is, Shayan is handsome. It is first statement. Now the second statement, he has blue eyes. When we combine together, student, P and Q, it means Shayan is healthy, is handsome. And has blue eyes. But if you write in conjunction form, disjunction form, P or Q, it means Shayan is handsome or he has blue eyes. So this statement represent here the compound proposition. It means it has some doubts about the Shayan is handsome or he has blue eyes. So we make a table because it has two variables. So we put here n is 2 because there are two propositions we have given. So 2 raised to the power 4, it means we make a truth table. It has four possible cases. It means the first statement it is true. Both are true. Or if it is false, or if it is true, then false, true, then false. When we make P and Q, if you find, and if you find P or Q. When we talk about this one, P and Q, it means in P and Q, it means conjunction. If you represent by and means, if you're applying their dot, represent by dot, or it means addition operation. So it means this one, it has four possible case, four possible results. The first statement it is true, and the second statement it is true, right? And the both statement of P and Q are true or false. So it means 1 + 1.1 it is 1. So we write it true. When we consider here, if true is 1 and false is 0, to understand easily conjunction and disjunction. So it means 1.0, it means 0. We write here F. 0.1, it is 0. It means F. We write here. And 0.0, it is 0. It means F. P or Q represent here addition operation. If we put here 1 + 1, it is 1. 1 + 0, it is 1. 0 + 1, it is 1. And 0 + 0, it is 0. So when we talk about conjunction and disjunction, it is conjunction statement and it is disjunction. Now, after the truth table, we will talk about different logical equivalence. Which statements are called logically equivalent? Student, if the proposition P and Q have the same truth values, in every possible case, that's why they are said to be logically equivalent. Equivalence, it is denoted by this symbol. For example, P is logically equivalent to Q. So it has some rules. Let me define you after that. So today, after that, we will consider and define the tautology contradiction and contingency. These are the very important terminologies used in mathematical logic or logic of reasoning. Now, what is tautology? A compound proposition that is always true for all possible cases. Of its variable. So this is known as tautology. Or in another words, if the last column of its of the truth table, if it will contain only T, it means that type of compound proposition is called tautology. Now, what is contradiction? A compound proposition that is always false. That is always false for all possible cases of its variables is called contradiction. Or in another way, if the last column of the of the truth table, if it will contain only F, F represent as false, that's why we call it contradiction. Now, what is contingency, student? A compound proposition. Now, what is contingency? Student, a compound proposition that is neither a tautology, that is neither a tautology nor a contradiction a compound proposition that is neither a tautology nor a contradiction this type of table is known as contingency table in mathematical logic it means And what is dual? The dual of a compound, the dual of a compound proposition, the compound proposition that contains only the logical operators on the logical operators what are the logical operators and or negation is obtained by replacing each and by or or by and Similarly, each T by F or each F by T or each F by T. This is called dual. The dual of S, the dual of S is denoted by S prime. So now, student, we have taken some problems about the contradiction tautology. So now, first problem about the tautology and contradiction. So show that the following proposition are tautology for example, the first question is P or negation P. The second one is, for example, negation P and Q. P and Q in the round bracket means whole negation of P and Q or Q. So, if the single proposition, a student, we will make the column P and it has two possible results. It may be true or it may be false. But when we find the negation of P represent here, student, it is false. If it is true, then false. Or if it is false, then true. It means opposite of the given statement. But when we combine with disjunction, so it means 1 plus 0, it means 1. We represent here true. 0 plus 1, it is true. So if the last column of the given table shows that true, all possible results are true, it means we call it tautology. Right? Tautology. Now, second example, then we consider solution in the first part. Now, the second part is PQ. It has four statements. For example, true, false. If it is true, false. Then we consider the conditions. P and Q, it means first we make P and Q. It means we applying the dot multiplication. It means 1.1, it is 1, represent by 2. 1.0, it is 0. 0.1, it is 0. 0.0, it is 0. It means the whole negation of P and Q, it means if it is true, then false. If it is false, then true. In the last column, so then, in the last step, student, negation P and Q or Q means this column, when we connect with or Q, it means or operation represent here addition student, because it is disjunction. So T plus F, it means 1 plus 0, it is 1. 0 plus 1, it is 1. 1 plus 1, it is 1. And 0 plus 1, it is 1. So the all statement of the proposition, all are true. That's why they call it tautology. Hence, proved. Now the next application is, when we talk about the contradiction. So verify that P and Q and negation P is contradiction. So when first we make two columns, the basic columns, they represent here true, true, false, false, or in the next column true, false, true, false. So first we find the negation of P. Negation of P represent here, if it is true, then false, false, true, true. Then we combine together, student, Q and negation P. Q and negation P means when we join Q with negation P, it means it has AND operation, so it means multiplication. So 1.0, it is 0, it means F. 0.0, it is 0, it means F. 1.1, it is 1, and 0.1, it is 0. But when we combine together with P, so it means the last column, it is P and Q and negation P. So it means when we join together and applying the addition multiplication operation, because AND, so 1.0, it is 0. 1.0, it is 0. 0.1, it is 0. It means F. And 0.0, it is F. So student, in the last column, if all possible cases, the result will be false. That's why we call it contradiction. Hence, proof. So the compound proposition, that is proposition that is always false for all possible truth values of its variable. That's why we call it contradiction. Now, student, I give you example about logically equivalence. The next example about logical equivalence. Now, logical equivalence. Now, question about logically equivalence. Use truth table show that negation P and Q, they are logically equivalent to negation P or negation Q. So first we make a table, student, find the solution. True, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. Negation P means opposite of negation, it means it is false, false, true, true. But negation Q means if it is true, then false, if it is false, then true. So we write in this way. When we join together negation P and Q, so first we make a negation P and Q. In the first column we will make It is, first we find only the P and Q. P and Q represent here, it means when we join together, but the operation is multiplication. 1.1 it is 1, it means true. 1.0 it is 0, it means false. 0.1 it is 0, then false. 0.0 it is 0, it means false. But the negation of P and Q it is true, then false. If it is false, then true. Right? Then we join these two columns, student, with the help of with operation or operation. So it means negation P or negation Q. When we join together with addition operation, student, or represent here addition. So F dot F plus F, it means 0 plus 0, it is 0. 0 plus 1, it is 1, it means 2. 1 plus 0, it is 1, it is 2. And 1 plus 1, it is 1, it means 2. So, student, can you see that the left hand side and the right hand side, when they are similar, it is left hand side and the right hand side, when they are similar, or in another way, they are equivalent, because each entry shows that they are similar. So that's why, hence, proof, they are logically equivalent. So thank you very much. Student, I have completed my lecture about the learning objectives. Thank you very much. Take care. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.